Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for waiting. You are joining the CowCast, where an abundance of hosts, namely Nate, Sean, Nick, Lewis, and Frankie, sometimes featuring other guests, talks mostly about video games and developments in the technological world for at least 1 hour. Warning. The show is recorded live and unscripted, so where they might try to follow the topics at hand, tangents and rants aren't just common, they are practically integrated features of the show. We hope you will enjoy your stay, and the show will begin shortly. Actually, it begins right now.
Moo moo, motherfucker!
Okay, so we should be back, Nick and Sean, take your audio.
Hello there.
Hello?
Ah, we got him. Let me know if there's a huge static noise, because my bar is telling me that it kind of... Did we lose Nick again? We lost Skype again, didn't we?
No, I'm here.
We totally lost Skype again.
I'm here, hello.
We're here. We're here.
Shit. Holy fuck. Fuck you, Skype.
What the fuck is going on anymore?
Fuck you, Skype.
Jesus Christ.
Holy shit. Okay.
How about this? We just...
7 minutes of technical difficulties later. All right. First topic of the evening. Go for it, Nick. Give us a rundown.
Go for it. Okay, hopefully people can hear me and I don't cut off midway. FIFA 16. Okay, you know how we were talking about before on a previous CowCast? They were like, man, we're going to add grills to that FIFA 16 because everyone wants grills, right? And then EA was suddenly like, you know what? We're going to remove like 13 of them for reasons they didn't even state. So, needless to say, some people are kind of confused about this shit. A lot of people are hyped because they're like, oh boy, I want to be a grill and kick balls because this sounds like fun. And now it just seems like they're going back on their promise. Just removing more and more players. Like, 13 seems like a lot of people.
Yeah, that does seem like a lot of people.
I had no idea if you heard any of that. So.
No, I did. We did.
All right.
I'm just not sure how many players are in the FIFA. Like, I'm assuming there's...
I looked, but it didn't say at all.
I'm assuming there's a full team roster. So there's what? I don't know how many teams there are in a... How many teams are there in a soccer, a FIFA league? Like 20? Yeah. If we say 20, so that's 20 and 20 people per team. So that's like 20 times 20 is like 400 because I can do math. You know, yeah, so I mean... So they basically removed a team. A team worth of players.
Yeah, but coincidentally... They removed a shit ton of people from Mexico and other places. Apparently, they removed people from Canada, from one person from Spain, and like six from Mexico.
It had something to do with their eligibility.
Mm. Sounds to me like America bias. I don't see any Americans on that list.
Well, yeah. So, here's the question. Well, first, like. I guess EA does. I was thinking EA Dice is in Sweden, but not all of EA is in Sweden. So I was thinking maybe it has something to do with just like Mexico didn't want their players on the game.
I don't know, maybe.
That's
the thing. I don't know how much say like FIFA actually has in these games. You know,
right?
If they can actually like dictate who they want in the game or not. I'm assuming they have some. Yeah, I'm assuming they can do stuff like
EA
that.
EA probably pays so much in licensing fees to get their people, like the people's names and stuff.
Yeah.
They remove people from Mexico because they jumped the border. That's horrible. Okay. I'm not sure that's the reason.
They are athletic.
Fish slap them. I'm just waiting for Lewis to say something in the comments.
I know. It just kind of seems weird, though, doesn't it? Because they made up like this big hype. They were like, oh, yeah, we're going to have all these like players. We're going to add in all these female players now because people are like pumped for that. You know, some people don't give a crap, but whatever. And now they just remove 13 at the same time. Like, no male players. Yeah, female players.
Right, that's a good point. So, like, the whole... Maybe it was just Mexico didn't want to do it, like, thing. They would have removed male players, too, right? I mean, that kind
of... I would assume so, unless, like, they have some different thing. It was six of them from Canada, six of them from Mexico, and one from Spain.
The article title was, like, budgeting didn't allow them to model them, right?
No.
Was that the
title? It just... Yeah. the title just says it's forced to drop 13 female players from FIFA 16. And I'm reading more of the article actually right now because I briefly read it earlier. It's basically ensuring the students' priority to remain quality education, experiencing that all the student athletes are competing like as to the level and not going pro. It's a double NCAA amateur rule that is prohibiting basically those 13 players. I'm pretty sure those players aren't completely fully signed onto teams, is what they're trying to say. And they're trying to be like, once they sign professional contracts, then they can earn the money and play professional and do all that stuff. But if they're not doing that, they shouldn't be in the game, is what I got.
Right. So why is, well, that makes sense.
Because
they're still
like nationally playing for that team, but they're student athletes. And if they go pro, and
right, as soon as they make money
from the game,
yeah, you know, we lost Sean.
Then technically they cannot play on us in college.
Yeah.
Oh, hello. I'm here.
You do. I'm pretty good, man.
You're having a good day.
Fuck you, Skype.
I've always been here. I've been here the entire time,
Skype,
folks. Yeah.
Skype for the win this week.
It's gonna keep on going.
No, so I mean, so these are probably all like these are Canada people and Mexico people. So they're probably all playing in the U.S., because of NCAA, and I mean that makes sense. They can't as soon as you earn a dollar from it, you're becoming a professional athlete. So,
yep.
I guess they're not, yeah. Because the following players will not be, yeah. I mean, that's straight, okay. But why is there no males on the list? That's a good question.
I don't know, because they were just like, well, we don't need this many females.
I
feel like it's just not a big enough problem.
It's like, it's weird, though, you know? I mean, maybe a lot of, the male players, the whole system is just like streamlined for them enough because I guess they've done this for games for like years at this point. Maybe it's just easier to get around it. I don't know, but it's like,
yeah,
it's weird that it's just like, yeah, here's just a big old list of females that won't be in a game. Well, if you want to play as them, well, you're fucked. So
you're just going to have to wait till the next update because that's all DLC. The games are. They are just DLCs.
No, this is not DLC. These people will not be in the game.
No, no, no. We ain't talking about that. I'm talking about the franchise of sports games are just the same game.
Yeah, pretty
basically,
much.
Basically, every game. Time.
Fuck you, EA, taking my money.
It was hilarious because I remember watching a video of a Madden gameplay in the early 2000s, and the AI was better in that Madden game in the early 2000s than it was in the 2010 version. It's like, how do you fuck up that much? You make the same game every year.
Yeah, all they do is a little bit graphics, switch players around, and make it a little bit better.
Yeah,
it's like goddamn iPhones. I'm sorry, rant of the century, but iPhones and sports games, they're the goddamn same thing.
Damn right.
I hate Apple. I hate sports.
Right, we're going off topic, so we're switching topics. It's a short topic, but we're running a little bit behind because of technical difficulties. So, on to topic number two. Okay.
Did you do the intermission?
Yeah, I did the intermission.
Yay.
I did it. I made the noise. All right, so Nick, this one, break us down. Yeah. Drop the link in the chat, please.
Oh, Jesus. Okay, well, I mean, there's not exactly too much about this. This is more of a announcement for everyone in chat. On Origin, currently right now, as they always do their little free games giveaway thing, however many, days or whatever, but currently on Origin, Command & Conquer Red Alert 2, a fan favorite of people who like that RTS life and Command & Conquer life, it is currently free, and all you have to do is click a button, and it's yours to keep forever, so.
That's pretty good, even though I own every other Command & Conquer game.
But do you own this one?
Yeah. I'm pretty sure I own this one. I got
can own it again.
Me and Jeff and Matt bought the entire Command and Conquer franchise for $12, every single game, 20 of them.
That's Christ. Ridiculous.
It was every game since 1990. So it's It's like ridiculous. Probably even earlier. I don't even know the times. This
is very reminiscent of the old ones.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah. Skype is still fucking up a little bit, but we're still rocking and rolling.
Skype and Twitch.
Okay. So sorry about the difficulties here, everyone. So Nick, what's your favorite RTS game?
Not Command & Conquer.
Well, what's your favorite RTS game?
I don't know, man. There's like so many. There's like RTSs and there's like mixed RTSs, dude. It's like are you talking about like base building RTSs or like battle RTSs?
Base building RTSs, and then we'll do battle RTSs.
Okay. Probably like Rise of Nations, and then before that would be like Age of Mythology, Age of Empires. I don't know. They're all very close, but they're good games. What about you guys?
My favorite one.
We don't play RTS.
Oh yeah, I forgot. Sean is
either Command and Conquer 3 or Battle for Middle Earth 2. I mean, it's gotta be one of those. Those are the good old day Xbox RTSs, man. I don't know. They're still fun on the PC.
Well, if you can play the multiplayer.
Well, if you can't play, which kind of sucks. But you need to like my school connection blocks certain type of games, so you can't play. Like all that stuffs, so it's like a little bit annoying because you can't really play online with servers and so forth. Fallout 4 is an RTS. Jared,
well, I haven't played that. No, the only RTS game I've ever played is Halo Wars.
God have mercy on your soul.
It was okay.
Okay. I'll let you believe that.
What?
Nothing.
I really enjoyed Halo Wars, but it's definitely not the best. But yeah,
it was just like you get in multiplayer and you join like a 2v2 or 3v3, and then you just literally tech to one specific super unit, and that's right.
It was really easy.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's all it was, and then you could like fucking warthog rush or whatever. Like
40 cancers. Warthogs. Terrific.
So 40 cancerous.
Warthogs with Goss wart, like Goss cannons and shit. I had that warthog rush down to a T.
Everyone loved him in multiplayer matches so much.
Yeah.
Am I right?
Mr. General, reporting for duty. Reporting for duty.
Nope. The worst.
Lewis,
that's the thing. It's like I don't mind playing like RTSs, but like when I get in like multiplayer RTSs, it's like, oh great, here comes the clusterfuck, you know?
No, I see. Like I like multiplayer RTSs with friends.
Yeah,
but I don't. But like
need to be the same skill level,
right?
Otherwise,
Yeah, I don't like RTSs online, or even any strategy game online.
Like, especially the older ones too.
Unless it's with your friend, because everyone there's like the people that are playing like the old ones, like all the Command and Conquerors are just elitists, because no one else wants to play the game. And if you're like a level like me, you're probably playing it to like with friends. So like I went on Command and Conquer
to have fun. They're playing it to like completely rape your mind with freaking whatever the hell they have in that game.
Right.
Those GDI super units. I don't know.
Like when I'm at home, I play it online because like it never lined up with like the friends that I have that have the game, that like it would never line up. Like one of them would be at school, so their internet would be blocked, and like my internet would be blocked one weekend, and like depends on when we were at school and stuff. And so I would play online, and then you just like instantly get rushed, and like the game's over within like 30 seconds because I haven't played the game in long enough to, well, in a long enough time, most recently to. Or to beat them. So I mean, and to stop rushes, it's like it's stupid.
Yeah, I don't know. And then it's just like whenever you play with friends, they always get like pissy over the littlest things sometimes too. Yeah. I still remember people got salty over my freaking rushes with freaking Urukai Berserkers.
Okay, those were bullshit though.
I don't give a shit. They can make them. I didn't have to research anything. I just made them.
They were bullshit.
And if you can't counter it, you can't counter it, mate.
That's all they I gotta were say. Fucking bullshit.
Pretty sure that's the point where I stopped playing the game.
Yeah, pretty much.
Everyone was like, fucking hate you.
Yeah. So, all right.
Stick to Europa, kids.
Stick to Europa.
Sadly, right. It's somehow some more simpler than that.
But it's like, that's a battle RTS, right? Still, like the RTS is battle.
Or not is really.
It, no, is it just?
It's more like just RNG statistics. It's just turn based. I guess it's kind of weird because it's like it has like a real time system, like you can pause the game and stuff. But it's more or less like turn based. It's like tick based, I guess, you know. So okay. It's like a day, like you have one movement, day you have another movement, but it's just straight through, right. Pretty much. You just go right through a month and you don't even have to pause. I don't know, it's weird. Basically, RTS games are crazy.
RTS games are, they're up there. Ruse is fun. So I played a little bit of StarCraft, didn't get too much into that. Haven't played Warcraft games.
They weren't RTS for like... Well, the RTS Warcrafts were like forever ago, aren't they?
Right, yeah. A long time ago. Yeah. But yeah, I haven't... Yeah, so... Yeah, I guess on to our next topic of the evening. We gotta do the transition!
Fuck!
Random noises. Random noises! All right.
Random noises.
So our... third topic of the evening is the Batmobile. Someone dropped a link. So we're going to be talking about whether we like the new Batmobile or some of the older Batmobiles. They have a new one coming out in the Batman v Superman jazz and stuff. So obviously, so this is a pretty picture of it. I haven't looked at it yet. All right, so this one looks... So
give us things.
This one looks very like sleek compared to the last one, which was like tank army, like seemed very army and armored compared to this one that looks more like what you would see in like the comic books.
Yeah, this one seems like he made it, not like the military. Yeah,
right. And like, I don't know, I think the military one was cool. Yeah. But I don't think it looks like the Batmobile. It made sense. It was a very practical one. It looked like this doesn't look practical at all.
Because I can't see Bruce Wayne building this, like a whole Batmobile. It doesn't seem very practical to me. You know, he's gonna like outsource it to like someone in Germany. Be like, yeah, can you make this for me? And they're just gonna be like, what the fuck are you using this for?
Yeah, I'm like, yeah. I don't know. I think the old one's better. I mean, there's definitely some comic book ones out there. Mm. What do you think, Sean?
I don't know. Compared to the last one, I don't like it. I liked the more practical looking, not practical looking one, the more practical using one. But obviously, it's not really Batman-y. But like, at the same point, I don't like the new one at all. I really kind of like the old fashioned ones. Not gonna lie, from like the 80s or 70s.
The one that looks
like
a car with wings on the back.
The actual one that looks like a Batmobile. Yeah, I'm trying to find like. All of them in a good picture, but I can't.
I don't know. I think those look retarded. They look like cars. I think we're way past that. Yeah, but like that's... That. I don't know.
We are way past that, but it's also a Batmobile. It's in the name. It's a mobile.
It's also...
So that's where I go from. I also like older cars, so that's my problem.
No, and no one else likes Wonder Woman's invisible car plane thing. No, just me. Why can't we just be like that, man? Simple, it's to the point. No one complains about it. I mean, they might, but...
They totally just ran out of, like, ideas to draw it. No, this it's actually probably, like, drawn in something, but just not...
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I also think it's funny, too, in this video, it's like, enter to win the Ultimate Studio Tour and a chance to sit in the new Batmobile. Just to sit in it? That's it?
And I'm gonna, like, ride
Can't
it?
Drive it around?
Drive it around? Yeah.
Yeah, like... What?
Why not?
That's a poop. That's a bad photo I put in there, but it's okay. It shows you what it looks like. We'll put another one in there because...
I can just see the sketchiness.
What? The,
The very first two on the left of the second one.
The middle one with, like, the...
Jesus Christ. Oh my God.
The crazy bat wings on it are weird. Yeah. But, like, you get, like, the old, like...
The second
one. Cadillac, and then you get the second one that's, like...
What this one
more
looks like.
More sportster.
Second one looks like what it's going to be, like except a little more
like
armored.
Like the comic one, like the early comic one.
Yeah, I like the very early comic one. But I feel like it's still, the new one isn't very much like those. I don't know. I watched it like two or three times, and it's like kind of like weird.
It's kind of weird.
Bats.
It goes back to it, but it goes like, it's like a pancake now. It's super flat.
Yeah, that's a good point. I think the practicality of this one, though, it needs to look grittier than those, like, the older ones. Just for them, to fit the movie. Because the entire movie is very gritty. Like, if you watch the trailers, like, the entire thing is, like, super gritty and
without
dark.
Without a doubt. It definitely fits the actual movie is going to be about and all that stuff. But at the same point, it's like, I can't even see it in this video. You see, like, bits and pieces of it. I want just, like, a boom photo of it.
I actually almost, like, think this one would have fit better in the Dark Knight series. Then like, this gritty armor one with, like, other superheroes. Like, I feel like with the other superheroes, like, the... I don't know.
I think they could flip-flop easily, yeah.
I almost feel like...
I just want a damn practical Batmobile with, like, fucking chain guns on it and rocket launchers. That's all I want. That's all I fucking want. Yeah, I don't care about the color. I don't care about the doodads and, like, the wings and shit.
He's not going to shoot people, though.
Bitch, please. He needs to just let loose, okay? He can take over Gotham like nothing.
With the money that he's got, man.
Your money. He can just punch everyone out and they'll be wrecked.
I don't know if he actually kills anyone, though. So.
I don't know if he's ever killed anyone. He probably has killed someone, but like a supervillain by them, like, falling or some bullshit. But
Yeah, never by his, like, actual hand or, like, weapon.
I don't know. Yeah.
When I mean hand, I mean, like, beating the poop out of him. The snots.
Beating the snots out of him.
Like, obviously, if he lets him go off of a falling bridge, then he dies, but like that.
Batman just has to go crazy, man. He needs to go postal.
Everything. He needs to just kill everyone.
What? That's what happened with Joker, though. That's what made Joker. He's crazy, Joker.
I mean,
not really.
Joker's pretty crazy. I mean, that's the point of his character.
Yeah.
I think he was rather sane.
No, I don't know about that, Nick. I don't know about that.
That was an interesting sound effect.
What about that Batmobile? All right, folks.
Is there anything else?
Next topic.
About the Batmobile? We're flying through these topics tonight.
Yeah, short ones, but
there wasn't much out this week, so we'll probably jump into some games after this. We're scraping the barrel this week,
but it's fine because we're still here, and that's what counts.
All right, so our fourth topic of the evening.
All right,
so our fourth topic of the evening is, what DLC do we want? So this is a topic basically asking, what DLC do we want? Because Nick found a game that he likes and a DLC coming out for it.
Yes, that's what that link I provided there was. We were kind of thinking about how we want to go about this topic, and we were just thinking, oh, well, what DLC would we be interested in? And Jack chime in and shit like that. But the main topic, or the main article, rather, was about Age of Mythology expansion. I doubt many people know what the hell it is, because the last time they had an expansion for Age of Mythology was about 12 years ago. So that shit's a while ago at this point. I was like 10 when that shit came out, like, basically. And yeah, it was a solid game. And, you know, they released it on Steam. They released an HD version, which, you know, I guess isn't without its problems because, I don't know, reasons. But yeah, quality game. And a good way to bring us into our discussion.
So I guess,
great DLC.
Yeah, so people in the chat, feel free to post whatever game you want, no matter how old it is, because obviously Age of Mythology hasn't had an expansion in a very long time.
Fuck.
So any game you want, what game would it be? And we're going to start with Nick. What would your game be?
Yes.
Any game.
Yeah. Man, I'm not ready for this. I'm not ready. Any game. Well, they could release a new expansion for Civ 5. Okay, hear me out. I know Sean's looking like
fine.
It's okay. They can release a new expansion for Civ 5 where, get this, you're in a spaceship, right?
Yeah,
going to another planet, and you can pick these different sponsors, right? And then you pick these sponsors, you go on a planet, and you land on it, and then you make, like, a little, like, colony, right? And there's, like, other ships that land all over the fucking place, and you can, like, fight aliens and shit. And then that'd be dope. They can put, like, mini DLC for, like, you know, water units and shit like that. It'd be pretty good.
You know, it'd be a cool. Like, you know, it'd be a cool name for that.
What?
Earth Beyond.
Oh, whoa! That's a mind blown.
Maybe. They should have just called it Alpha Centauri too, though. I think people would have liked that a lot more than this Earth Beyond shit.
Yeah. Yeah, Earth Beyond doesn't sound right. Maybe.
I don't work at Firaxis. I wouldn't fucking.
Maybe
know.
Like Beyond Earth. That sounds like a better. It
sounds
name.
Familiar almost. I think someone made that.
Someone made that? Oh, darn. Okay,
beats
can't,
me.
We can't
my
name.
Topics. My idea is probably bullshit anyways. But yeah, what about Sean? What do you want?
Well, okay. So I got a couple because they're kind of just easy, fast topic ones. And we got time, obviously. We got time.
Yeah.
So we'll start off with
I
got to
think
spades.
About some because that's a fucking
yeah. yeah, let you think about some. I'll fill in some like random bullshit ones here. I don't know. I just started playing Ace of Spades, and I was like, yo, they could definitely, like, make this game a lot better with some, like, DLC shit, and they've never done that, so that will never happen.
He
but
could have one okay. game to choose any DLC for, and he chooses
hey.
A fucking indie game
hey.
By Steam that he's
I
on
have,
for three
like,
days.
I've had five, and I've owned it for actually 3 years, just haven't played it since today.
It's true. I was there.
It's true. Look up my other SeanBot account, and it's right there, the only game that I owned that didn't transfer over. But we're going to go on. Battlefield Bad Company 2 could have a great DLC there.
What kind?
Be anything.
What kind of DLC?
I don't know, man.
There was
any
like
kind of 50 DLC.
DLCs for that game.
There was.
Crazy new DLCs that I don't have.
Crazy
which could
new...
be any of them, really.
Oh. Details. What
I don't
what
got no details.
Time.
I just want some cool ass shit. I want some, like, this goes into the next thing. I want Vietnam, Rising Storm, Red Orchestra 2. Just thrown onto my plate in front of
me. We should link Sean.
No. Because
be
I know.
Developed like
I know. There is something developing, but I want it now.
Two things actually developing.
There's an actual like game made
it,
by the company coming out.
Yeah,
in, like,
there's
I
a
know.
Mod for.
I know, and there's a mod. Yeah.
You can't suggest a DLC that's already becoming a game.
I mean.
You said one game. I'm giving you like four or five, so I don't just don't give a damn to begin with. So, to go on, you know, that's been something Nick and me and Nate probably have wanted for a long time. So that needs to be done. And if it's not done effectively, we'll get mad. Real mad.
Yeah.
And then, you know, like, I don't know. The Forest is also an indie survival game, but, like, you know, it could definitely pull something off than just the islands. Like, maybe you crash in the fucking Arctic or some other, like, area. So, like, something like that would be cool. Mm-hmm. And those are the ones I can think of.
Yeah, I think for the Bad Company, it would be dope if they made, like, a World War II DLC, but it's just, like,
yeah.
I almost want them to make a separate game for that.
Yeah, like, I would rather them make a separate game, but, like, they could so pull off remaking 1942 into, like, a real decent, like, game or DLC.
I mean, they kind of sort of tried that, but not really.
They did.
43 was it. It was all right.
That was back when, though?
1943.
Yeah, man. That was, like, 1943.
Yeah. I don't know. I think overall, they just need to make a Bad Company 3, like Lou said. But so that's not a DLC,
yep.
though.
But it's going to be a modern one, and I want a World War II one.
Yeah.
Expansion.
Okay.
Yes.
So the
that's
DLC that I want. For God's sake, just
ready
give
yourself.
Me fucking dinosaurs in Battlefield.
I've given up on that.
Just give me fucking dinosaurs. They literally just need to make Dino D-Day in the Battlefield engine. Literally, that's it. That's all they need to do. There's a game just called Dino D-Day on Steam. It's like on sale. When it's on sale, it's like 50 cents. Otherwise, it's like $10 or something crazy like that. But it's like made on like the Source engine, but by far the most fun you'll ever have. Dino D-Day. But
oh,
Battlefield
really?
Edition. That's what we want.
I don't want to like stoke the fire to get anyone super hyped for any possibilities, but does anyone know, and I know this is going to sound kind of weird, does anyone know if there is a dinosaur-esque species or world in Star Wars lore? I don't know.
That's interesting.
Because
like you do have
George,
some
yeah, George Lewis. George Lucas could just make up tons of bullshit. He made like that like weird like mantis thing, and what was that other thing in the Clone Wars movie?
The big
triceratops weird thing.
The big dinosaur with like the weird mouse cat
thing.
Yeah. Now, what if they had dinosaurs in an upcoming title made by EA? Think about that. Not going to say which title because I don't want to get anyone super hyped because I ain't even riding that hype train in the first place. But you never know.
Are you just saying this or do you actually have proof?
I may have a source.
Said source of the variety that will not be named on the couch.
That Battlefront will have dinosaur DLC?
You never know, man. People have said it about the past four Battlefield games. So why not say it about this one?
I think this one is like the least likely to have it.
You never know.
It's the most likely to have it.
But if you think about it, every other Battlefield has had so many Easter eggs and so many maps based on like dinosaur-esque locations and shit like that. I've
been waiting for this, man.
And you haven't heard anything about dinosaurs in Battlefront. Have you heard anything? No.
No, they're fucking teasing us.
Just going to be like, here you go, bitch.
The new Battlefield Hardline, one of the Levolutions events, is like they're robbing a museum, I think. And dinosaur bones can like kill you. Like they like tumbles over.
Indeed. But there's no dinosaurs in that game, is there?
No, but like I wouldn't be satisfied if they were in Battlefront.
Yeah, it'd be pretty.
Because in Battlefront, I expect.
Because they kind of fit in there, yeah.
Because I expect weird creatures. So I expect that whole aspect of so I think it'd just be boring as fuck. Oh, that's kind of funny. MC Country Gaming just put boring as fuck in the chat as soon as I said that. I think it's just funny that I said it. I think it'd just be boring as it would be no different than like playing any other Star Wars game. Like, I'm expecting creatures, so it's kind of like a slap in the face if we get it in Battlefront, because it doesn't fit in too well.
Yeah,
that it doesn't.
That is true.
That it wouldn't seem like dinosaurs.
As long as I can kill Ewoks as like Tusken Raiders, I'm set.
I really want it in Bad Company 3.
Doubts, man.
Because if any game had to have it in the next like couple Battlefield games, it would be Bad Company 3. You know it's true, though. Come on. You know, like, it's like the most cartoonish
really
of it. It's like the most, like, abstract one of, like, the entire, like, all the Battlefield
games. That's the thing. It's I guess it's the most cartoonish and the less likely to put it in just because I don't think they give that much of a fuck.
Yeah.
But at the same point, I would think, like, EA's like, oh, everyone liked Battlefield 3 and Battlefield 4 and they bought a shit ton more copies of those. Let's just put it in that game because it's super popular. And I could just see them not putting it in there.
Yeah.
I don't know.
That's true.
I don't know. But we just need a fucking Battlefront. Or not Battlefront. We need a Bad Company 3.
Maybe
already getting a goddamn Bad
Give me a better graphic. Bad Battle Company 2. Bad Company 2. I would take it. This would be like just give me a better graphics. Like, leave the engine alone. I will go back.
Do a Redux, yeah.
I will go back to engines, like to the original Frostbite instead of Frostbite 3 and be like, yo, fuck this. Give me Bad Company 3.
It's upgraded.
Give me
like
Dino DLC.
Anything. Dino. Well.
Like, if they did a Bad Company 3, you could probably pull in, like, everything they've done with, like, Vietnam. You could put in the World War II shit, because they obviously had that in Bad Company 2, kind of, like, as viewing it and playing it a little bit. And then you can do all the modern stuff, too.
I also had Vietnam in Bad Company 2.
Well, yeah, they had the expansion back for that. So, like, that Battlefield Bad Company 3 could be a tie-in with everything that they have already produced. It's not that hard.
Yeah. I think it would just be interesting maybe if they just, maybe not even necessarily like a Battlefield game, but just a game where it's just like you're not stuck to one time period.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So it's like you get thrown into a game and it's like, oh, this is a World War II map in a World War II setting, so you have World War II guns and maybe like some like sci-fi-ish like German shit or whatever, right? And then it's like, oh, now you're fighting like a Vietnam one, so you have like Vietnam guns. Now you're fighting like a modern one, so you have like modern guns. And kind of have like separate things for that.
And then you also have like a cross culture with that. Like, you can get like so many nations out of that. So it's like not just, oh, U.S. versus Russia. U.S. versus Russia. U.S. versus Russia.
You won't get that in bad company. All that.
Yeah.
I don't think that's... But you won't. You can get that in a game, but I don't think you're getting that in bad company. Because there's like an actual storyline that like continues in bad company.
Yeah, but I'm just talking about multiplayer.
Yeah, but still, I don't know. I think the mass will go along with the campaign, just like they always do. So you can't really have, I don't know. So you won't have like campaigns like that. You won't have multiplayer mass like that if you have a campaign that like continues.
Well, yeah, it wouldn't work for it, but it's just a cool concept that Battlefield should take up.
Yeah, I think like that'd be cool. Just get every war. That'd be, I think honestly, that'd be awesome. Two maps from every war on launch, and then every DLC you launch like one, you could do like modern, you do World War II in Vietnam, and I guess one or Korea.
I still want a World War I game that runs really well.
Oh, bro, yeah. Revolution.
God damn it.
Well, like, what about those?
What about what?
What about the Revolution and the Civil War, man?
Fuck that, man.
You got those kind of people.
Nah.
Go back and play those Sister Channel games, and you'll see why you don't want a game based off that.
Yeah. That reloading.
So
boring.
They just like opt out of it. They're like, man, people really don't want to do this. So they give them like the bullshit guns that like no one ever had in the war.
Yeah.
Like
here's a repeater rifle. Everyone used it.
Yeah. It's like I'm an infantry foot soldier.
Seems legit.
All right. On to our next topic, because we are way off topic.
it's fine.
We turned into Bad Company 3, another random
Bad Company 3. Want to have a discussion about games, and that's fine.
Okay, next topic.
All
right, topic 5 for the evening is The Jungle Book. So I think if you were a kid at all, you definitely watched the original Jungle Book. Nick dropped the video link into the chat to the trailer. I think the original Jungle Book was... I don't know. What year did it come out?
1894.
Yep. Oh, so the book. Original. Like the book came out.
Yeah, the book. Okay. Well, that's what you said. book, not the movie.
And then the movie. When did the movie come out? Do we know? Like the cartoon movie?
Early 90s, maybe. I could check.
Yeah, early 90s. Late 80s, probably. So,
yeah.
Good shit. Childhood stuff right there. Because the bare necessities, man.
1996.
Just the simple bare necessities of life.
Actually, there's a couple here. There's one that was in 1967.
Just the bare necessities. The simple bare necessities of life.
I think 1967 is the one we're thinking about, though. Yeah, 67? Dude. 67. That's old as fuck movie, dude.
Yeah. They're pretty fucking old, man. I think a lot of the cartoon movies that you think we like that we watched as a kid are a lot older than you think.
Yeah.
Like interesting.
70s and shit, easy.
Like I think. Like there's like I think the Aristocats is like the late 40s or something crazy like that. I
think so.
And like Cinderella is probably pretty close, to, like pretty far back. I think a lot of those are.
Yeah, a lot of them were from the 40s, like after World War II and shit.
Yeah, I think they're a lot. They're a lot later than you think they are, or a lot earlier than you think they are. Yeah. I think it's crazy. Okay, so I don't necessarily remember the plot too much.
Neither do I. Some kid in the jungle animals and shit.
Other than the talking animals, the kid in the jungle, and the good animals need to save it from the bad animals. And the bad animals are the tiger and the snake. And the good animals is Baloo, my boy Baloo, the bear, and I can't remember the panther's name. But you got
the link.
It's in the link. Yeah, except I didn't open all the links before the stream started, so I can't, or I will lose your pictures.
Apparently, though, just a random fact. I know, you know, you're like mid-sentence, but fuck it. I just want to say anyways. Apparently, The Jungle Book, because of its immoral tone, came to be used as a motivational book by the Cub Scouts.
Oh, interesting.
Look, all the Tiger Scouts can beat all the Bear Scouts up.
Yeah. Oh boy. It all makes sense now.
We are lied to.
It's kind of
so
funny.
Lied.
How? I don't know. I don't see how that's a Boy Scout motivational thing coming from three.
Because Rudyard Kipling back in the day was a very, very powerful man when he wrote the book. I think that's why. So he's like, yeah.
Boy Scouts, do it now. I think The Jungle Book is one of my, I think, the childhood movies that I watched, like, probably the most, one of them. Except I can't
definitely
remember.
Definitely wasn't The Wizard of Oz.
Definitely wasn't The Wizard of Oz.
Never. Is that, like, I'm confused. Details.
I am mortified.
He has a child.
Is it the witch scene? When she's looking in the crystal ball or some bullshit or whatever it is?
Every scene with it.
It's every scene? Okay.
It's
every
the monkeys flying.
So,
it's a tree.
When I was like 3 or 4 or something crazy like that, it was playing in the movie theaters. Obviously, the movie's way older than that, but they brought it into color and they played it in the movie theaters for like a certain like couple weeks or something like that. Mm. And we went to see it. And I was scared shitless. Because, you know, like the big screen and like Green Lady, even though like today I would like laugh at it and be like, damn, that's retarded that I was scared of that. I would like have nightmares. I had nightmares for like years after. Like,
years.
Like, I saw the movie once. Like, it's not like I saw the movie a second time or something. I was still scared of it. I saw the movie once. And I had nightmares for like probably until I was 10.
Jesus, I've seen that movie like so many fucking times. I've been perfectly fine.
Probably even if I watched it like closer at like 10, I probably would have been like, yo, this is like not scary at all.
But then again, neither of you have seen what the fuck is that? Nightmare Before Christmas. So
no,
you guys are plebs.
But like that's like cartoon, so it's like different. I don't know.
Yeah, but that was pretty fucking dark.
Yeah, I guess so.
I think I would probably be more afraid of that than fucking The Wizard of Oz for sure.
Courage the Cowardly Dog.
It was on par with that. I mean, obviously, like a bit less, but Courage the Cowardly Dog was fucked up shit.
That was some real fucked up shit.
Yeah, it was great. But besides that, the Jungle Book. Did you guys hear though? They're coming out with a new movie.
Whoa! I think we already talked about it. We mentioned that.
We didn't mention it very much, now did we?
There's a trailer for it.
There's a trailer for it. What do you guys think about this trailer?
It looks pretty damn awesome. Action, man, with CGI, man. Like, realistic looking shit.
Snake Scarlett Johansson.
Okay, I don't even know how I feel about that. I don't approve of that.
I don't know.
I don't remember her being a lady either. I don't remember the snake being a lady.
I don't even remember the snake at all, so I don't know.
I remember the snake being like a
guy.
Maybe. A goofy guy. I think I remember the snake being like female, but it sounded like a male.
Yeah. It's like the same thing in Tarzan. Tarzan's best friend, like the ape that's with him, or the gorilla or whatever it is a female. And you always think it's a male.
Right, yeah. Because it just sounds like, I don't know. I just feel
the voice sounds like a female, or feels like a male, but it's a female.
Right, and then, every time, I don't know. I just think every time like you hear the voice, it just makes you think of a male. And then randomly, like, the characters would reference her as like a she or something, and it would be like, yeah, I don't know.
It's the same concept.
I have to listen to the old like the movie Snake voice, but I don't approve of Scarlett Johansson as that voice. From what I remember, that doesn't sound right at all. The bear didn't even fucking talk.
It's worse though.
Yeah, nothing talked other than that snake, which
the monkey didn't talk.
I don't think anything else talked.
Monkey definitely talked, because that monkey was like fucking singing and shit. I remember that. That is the one scene I remember.
Yeah, there's like a whole dance scene with the monkeys, and then they realize that they're not monkeys because they dress up as monkeys or something.
I don't know.
Because I can remember like he's like in a, it's like completely obvious, like hula skirt, and then like the coconuts on his mouth.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. I kind of Baloo talked.
No. All the animals talked in the actual movie, but the trailer doesn't show them talk. That's what I
said. Baloo talked.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I watched it a couple of days ago, so I can't remember.
Beats me.
I don't know. I think it's gonna be good. I think it's honestly something I might go see in theaters.
It's one of those. It's one of those films, though, man. It's like you remember, like, yeah, this is like my childhood and shit, right?
But you can't remember what the fuck's about.
Yeah, and then you also look a little bit deeper into the movie and you realize there's some kind of sketchy shit in it.
Yeah.
I mean, yeah.
Like, you can look it up, but the guy who wrote the book was pretty fucking next level, like, MLG imperialist racist. Like,
yeah.
He wrote a book called The White Man's Burden. Nuff said.
So, that was a good book. I'm pretty sure I read it.
I don't know. I don't know.
I'm sure I read it for school.
Yeah.
It's interesting.
I don't know, Rudyard Kipling, what a guy. He's making children's books now after basically conquering Africa. Next level.
Man. Okay.
Childhood. It's a fucking weird thing, isn't it?
It is.
Jesus.
Kind of looks like the life of Pac.
They gotta make it entertaining, only because there's a fucking tiger.
The tiger, and it's like an Indian boy.
Yeah. India-ish. It's kind of like, what the fuck is that movie? Life of Pi.
That's what he just said. That's what he just said. That's how that target. That's how it started.
I know. It's just what it, I just had to re-say it. It's just.
Yeah, just Nick's like it. Nick's still mind blown by our life hack of infinite power right here.
It's stop
power
life strip. Hacking. Life that's illegal. Hack. I'm gonna call the internet police. Mm-hmm.
Just a little tidbit for all of them.
I don't know.
I'm pretty sure if you plugged like another cord into, like an extension cord into that, you would short circuit that entire thing. So make sure you don't do that.
This wouldn't work because there's no power in it.
If you plugged like an actual cord into it that had power.
Yeah, no, it'd fuck up this thing so bad.
I'm pretty sure that might fuck up. Actually, I don't know.
Who knows?
No, I don't think so because those. Actually, that would be interesting. I don't know. I don't think so.
Because it's also a surge protector too.
Because they're in parallel. Who knows? They're in parallel, but then you're at. Yeah, it'd probably short circuit. Okay. Math, engineering, electronics. On to our last topic of the evening. VR topics.
Oh boy.
Da, da, da,
so this is the part of the stream where you, the viewers, get to ask viewer questions and topics. So you get pitch topics or ask us questions that we can answer. Please keep it clean, and we'll give you like 2 minutes to do it as usual. So start dropping the questions, and we'll get Question Master Sean to start reading them. If you dropped them up early before, please retype them again so we can see them down below.
I'm not looking for them.
Yeah. Ow. Go for it.
He just like, fuck.
Shots fired.
It's like, fuck
shots
your comments. Fired. I ain't looking for them. Jesus, Sean.
Shots fired already.
Well, I'm going to look for them because I'm useful.
Gosh. I don't think there was any.
That many. Yeah. What is up with airplane food, Sean?
Hey, don't worry. No, we
that's
ain't
Sean's
there yet.
Job to read. Okay,
what is
Sean,
up
start
with
reading.
Airplane food?
Lewis did it to me last week, and now you're doing it to me, Nick. I have one job.
One
what
job.
Yes, one
host
job.
Airplane food.
And read questions and look pretty. So that's three jobs.
But what's up with airplane food?
Fuck it. We're doing it.
Read the questions, Sean.
Oh, it hasn't been 2 minutes. It's been a minute. I'm looking at the clock.
Read
to start
the fucking
at.
Questions. There's
questions right there. We can discuss them
read
as we wait.
The fucking
fine.
Questions.
I will read right. The questions, you know. What happened to the show or the CowCast pre-show that was supposed to happen every week?
That was never confirmed.
That was never confirmed.
That was
a one time happening in
no,
you know.
What happened was school started.
What?
School started and I didn't get back from so I get at,
yeah,
every week
to...
now I get out of class at 4:50. Then from 4:50 to approximately 7:30 I have to go to practice and get food.
That's a no for pre show.
And then it takes about pretty much from 7:30 to the second the show starts to set it up. There's a lot of stuff behind the scenes, like all these topics. We have to find topics. We were off a couple last weeks with finding topics because nothing really was good out. So that's why we haven't had a pre-show in the last
great
couple weeks. So, yeah.
And then also the overlays, you have to custom make them right there and then. And then, you know.
By now I have them all. So, like the topic overlays.
You had to. Once in
a
while.
Set up the cameras and get Steam messages sent out to all you people so you come watch and all that stuff. So I don't know. There's a lot of stuff to do in the short period of time that I would usually take an hour to do slowly, and now I have a half hour to do it. So
yeah, I just kind of show up.
Yeah,
there you go.
We just pop up and be like, hey,
kind of show up.
What's it going?
Well, we're gonna be playing games after this, so for
oh
a little
my,
bit, hopefully.
Really?
Yeah.
Right, next question,
okay.
Sean.
Next question. Short
skip that
circuit.
One. Lewis is an idiot.
I don't even know. What's up with this airplane food?
What is up with airplane food? Well,
I don't know.
Considering the only plane I've ever been on was a remake of a 1929 biplane. That's the only plane I've ever flown on in my entire life.
Damn.
I cannot comment on airplane food because that food
was
no food served in that short half-hour flight.
They have nice drinks served, alcoholic beverages if you're in the first class variety sometimes.
Get them
and,
anywhere,
you know, peanuts. Yeah, no, it is anywhere, but, you know, being underage, they serve you Coke and Sprite and bubbling lemonade sometimes.
Coke products, man, they have the fucking airline racket
they
do, down.
They got it like...
God.
Just like trapped them. You can't get out now. It's like one of those finger traps, Chinese finger traps. Mm-hmm. But, you know, next topic, because...
Reasons.
Unless something about air food. I'll take that as a no.
Sure.
So why does Sean stream while I'm in school? Because I started school, and when I get time to stream, it's when I stream. It's then I don't have like a set schedule yet, and probably
Sprague.
Won't have one for a while.
Sprague, I gotta break it to you, man.
We're in college.
Fuck you. That's what Sean's saying to you right now. No, we love you.
No.
We love you. You're awesome. But that's what Sean's saying to you right now.
All I'm saying is. It's if I can get a stream in for an hour between classes, I'll do it. If I can't, then I won't.
I didn't see you do it today, man.
I didn't because I didn't have time.
Well, there you go.
If a potato had sex with a donut, .. would become Super Saiyan.
Wait, hey, we...
We're
losing him.
Questions because you're...
We're losing him.
I'm
the defibrillator.
We're losing him. Hi, Sean.
Hello. Oh,
get a screenshot. Get a screenshot. Get a screenshot.
Got him.
Got him.
Love my fucking job. Jesus Christ.
That's
can you
hilarious.
Hear me now?
Yeah, we
good.
Can hear you, but you're still...
<He's> still...
I'm still frozen?
Yeah.
Got him.
Okay, well,
got
I'll read him. The next topic and you guys can talk.
Oh, okay. I hear you now, I think.
Is a potato had sex with a donut? Would that make super... Okay, next question. Why does it seem like Nick wears the same shirt every time?
I don't, man. I'll show you. Those are all the shirts. I can't even actually point it. Those are all the shirts over there, and I got more that I can't fucking fit because I have
they
no
They seem
room.
To be all the same color. Or
they think
color, same
shade. They're the same make, I guess. And they are all darker colors because dark is the color of my soul, and it is an outward expression of me. Yeah. There you go.
All
right. Enough
said. Yeah. Why does Nate have Wookiee?
You
exclamation
totally
point
missed
Wookie.
That one. You totally missed one. What would happen if Call of Duty took a break from Lewis?
Oh, I thought I said if the call took a break. The world would actually be possible to run, and it wouldn't be shit, and there wouldn't be games that were poop that were put out every year.
There would
and
be
just
no
take,
racial hatred in America.
Yeah, there probably wouldn't be.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Confirmed.
Confirmed.
Yes, that is good. Mm-hmm. Death Teddy Bear says, FIFA 16 is dead.
Why does only Nate have Wookiee? So that you come to my stream to use Wookiee.
Exactly.
If everyone had the same sound effects, it wouldn't be fun to go to other people's streams.
It's true.
Yeah.
It's science.
16 is Bay. Welcome, my boy Chris, and welcome, Cap Member, to the stream. You're a little bit late, but feel free to drop some viewer questions if you got them. And Cap Member, you mentioned that you haven't seen one of these talk shows in forever. We do this every week. Same
every
time.
Week. Can you believe
Monday,
this shit? It's crazy.
8 p.m. EST. All right, so Sprog answers the question. Go, Sean. Second last comment.
His question is, do any of you play an instrument or did play an instrument in school?
Totally.
I tried.
He tried playing the drums.
So, I know, I tried playing the viola, which is a smaller or a larger version of the violin. It's a deeper version of the violin between the cello and the violin. That lasted 3 weeks.
Three weeks.
It probably lasted
one.
A little bit longer than that. Then I tried playing the snare drum, which was like a couple years, but I was never really good at it. I never really read the music. I learned like the marching parade song by like just doing it a bunch of times. I had no clue what I was doing until I listened to it a bunch of times. So I really had absolutely no clue what I was doing. And I don't have any rhythm at all.
Anyone else?
I played the trumpet.
Trumpet?
Yeah, I played that since 6th grade to like 8th grade, and then I was like, fuck this shit, don't got time in high school, and yeah, we stopped playing it. I sucked at playing, and I was good when it was easy stuff, and then when it got hard, I was like, boop,
Boop. Boop. Ah. And then he started playing the cymbal. That's fine.
It's yeah. It's like the little like pop up guy. Do 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 do.
I played the recorder.
The recorder, best instrument. Nick, do you remember playing that?
Totally. I think I actually used it once.
Did you have to play it? Because we went to a different school.
Not like for anything like we, besides just like a music class.
Like we had a music class.
Well, we spent like the entire music class for like 4 months doing it.
Jesus Christ. I just remember when I went to my music class, it's like, here's a recorder. You can play with it for today. Now let's sing karaoke bullshit. Yeah. I'm just like, what?
Yeah. All right. Next question.
How long did you ask me if I played any instruments?
Did you play any instruments? You already said no.
No, I said I didn't play any loser instruments. I played the fucking bagpipes, and I wore a kilt, and I had a fucking claymore.
No, you didn't.
And I killed motherfuckers with
that. No, you didn't.
So I'm the real
MVP. You did not. You have not played the bagpipes. I have never heard that before, and you're fucking lying.
It's the truth, man.
No, you're fucking lying. Fun
fact, there was a guy in World War II in Normandy who was storming the beaches. He had a kilt, a bagpipe, a bow and arrow, and a claymore. And he fucking shot people with the bow and arrow and killed them. Fun fact, that was past life.
Oh, yeah. My God. Sounds like it. Okay, next question is, how long have you guys been playing together?
2 years, Nick. Baby.
Well, yeah. Shut the fuck up.
What? Well, what defines playing is the question. Games?
How long have we known each other? How long have we been playing games together?
Let's start with how long have we known each other.
We've known each other since like first grade?
No.
Right?
No, not that late. Well,
I've known Mike since then.
It was probably Boy Scout, so fifth grade. Other than the one time
I remember beating you one time before that because I ripped you out of your fucking Yu-Gi-Oh card.
You fucking asshole.
It was so worth it.
You fucking asshole.
So worth. I don't know. Yeah, it's been a while. I guess it's more or less. It's like a safe answer. Was when we were in Boy Scouts, which was in like fifth grade.
Yeah,
I guess that was when like we really all knew each other.
Then I met him like 2 years later. Yeah, and I've known Nathaniel for 18. Soon to be 19 next Sunday. This upcoming Sunday.
We're gonna do this on a stream, so I have witnesses. Shit. You will not be getting a birthday present.
Jeez,
I haven't got one for the past 5 years.
Yeah, that's a lie. That's a lie. You got a sweatshirt last year.
He got me a sweatshirt that he
that
got
the
me
equivalent
2 years
of
ago.
Like, that was the sweatshirt. Equivalent of like 3 birthday gifts, money-wise.
Nah.
Yeah. Nah.
You should have just asked the parents to give it to me.
No.
Go for it. No, I'm just kidding. But that answers that question. We got tons more to do. If you got a Batmobile, can I be your Robin? Yes, Chris, if that's
okay, so that's Chris. One night at dinner. Okay, Chris is crazy, but we love him.
Crazy
one night at dinner, I was wearing a Batman shirt, and Chris just goes, "You're Batman, I'm Robin," and pulls out a raw egg from his pocket and puts it on the table.
I mean, to be honest,
no,
I'm not really surprised at this point.
No, like, this literally pulls out an egg just like out of nowhere. It was dinner time, so there was no eggs. It wasn't hard boiled. They don't even give raw eggs at the school. He lived in a freshman dorm, so he didn't need like couldn't cook for himself. and then we got like a picture 3 weeks later of him like holding it under a light, saying it's about to hatch. The same fucking egg. Oh, Chris, you're. God damn it, Chris.
Wait, was it actually one that was going to hatch?
No.
No? Okay. That would have been cool if it was. Like, he was incubating it in his pocket, man. Like, who knows? Maybe he's that crazy. Okay, next question. Would you rather be 7 foot or 4 foot? I don't know. That's really hard. Those are shitty heights.
I'd rather be 7.
Probably.
Yeah.
I don't want to be a small person.
But you don't want to. Do you want to be a huge person?
Well, 4 feet is like 9 inches below being a midget.
Yeah, that is true.
Yeah, that's
technically a midget, but most midgets aren't 4'9". So
besides, if we're like 7 feet tall, we could like join the circus as like fucking the Cyclops, giant man, or some bullshit like that. That'd be great.
Okay.
So playing games with each other, looking down at a cat member again. I guess I've played games with Nick since like ninth grade. I didn't have a console that you had until then.
But did you go over his house and play anything?
Well, of course.
Well, there you go.
Yeah.
I played earlier.
Okay, cool.
It's ninth grade.
Yeah, that's a good question for Chris from Sprake. How didn't it break in your pocket? We'll let you answer that in the chat. And yeah, I don't know.
You guys have any cats? I have four. Sean has four too.
Where does that say that? Cats.
Death Teddy, my boy Chris.
Yeah.
Do you guys have? Oh yeah, we have four.
May not have a couple gatos here and there. may or may not show up on stream from time to time.
Hashtag cats. For the last question. Hashtag cats.
There you go.
Favorite pet animal.
Clearly a zebra.
Cat.
Yeah.
No. Giraffes. Baby giraffes, man. Miniature ones like yay big. That's where it's at.
All right, I think that wraps up viewer. Yeah, that's pretty much all the viewer topics and questions for this week.
Yeah.
Thanks for coming out, everyone, and checking out the CowCast this week. As I mentioned before, we do this every Monday at 8 p.m. EST. So if you've missed the last couple of weeks and so forth, I'm going to answer that question quick. We all took Spanish. Last question there in the chat. Mm. Cool. What languages did we take in school? Chat. Spanish.
Totally. All right. Good. So keep everyone, going.
Thank you for coming out and checking out the CowCast. As I said before, we do this at 8 p.m. EST every Monday. If you missed the last couple, we're here every Monday. We haven't missed one yet. We've done a game night once, but we haven't missed one yet. I think Sean and Nick are going to jump into to do some gaming right now. Sean, did we get any followers this weekend or this week?
Sadly, not this week during the actual stream, but... You know, we did get a couple followers here and there, so thank you for watching.
The good thing is we're recognizing names. I recognize all the names of people in the chat, so we're getting regulars. Thanks for coming out and being supportive over all the weeks of the CowCast. Hope you enjoy it. If you have any suggestions or topics that you would like us to discuss in the coming week, feel free to drop links and ideas into the chat, and we'll review them after the stream, and maybe they'll show up in next week. Save all of next viewer topics for next week. Come up with some good ones. We want to hear them. We got some crazy stuff to talk about. And, everyone have a wonderful evening, and we will see you next week.
Hey there, viewers, and welcome back. My name's Sean Bogg, and I wanted to tell you a little bit about myself. I'm an environmental earth science major by day and a gamer by night. I started off streaming not knowing much about it, but with the help from my friends and my brother, we have grown the stream to what it is today. Make sure to punch that follow button, share us around, and donate to both the stream and St. Jude's Children's Research Hospital. The slogan, "Let's Fight Cancer for Freedom," has become a staple of the stream because I want to help out by showing some love, finding the cure, and saving some children by playing games. Thanks again for watching here at Sean Bod Gaming.